I'm here to see y'all.
And really?
And I went to whore myself out to iTunes, actually.
How was that?
Because they're in San Jose.
But hey, it's Pride Month. You're here at the perfect time.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Because every state has its own Pride Month, or is it the
same? Has their own Pride weekend, but it's usually June. Yeah.
Yes, perfect. Mm-hmm.
Our big weekend is at the end of the month, though, so you have to come back.
Well, I have a song for you.
All right.
That I wrote for you, so I suppose if you know. What's it called? Big Queer?
You have a little penis.
I suppose you bet on that team now that we have been talking about the peni.
Yeah.
It's called Peacock.
Really?
Yeah. Are you brave enough to let me see your peacock?
Is that in the song?
Don't be a chicken boy.
Is that what it's like?
Acting like a biatch.
When is this out?
It's going to be out, hopefully, sometime it'll leak. I hope.
The peacock's going to leak?
Peacock leak. No, it's a fun song. Hopefully we'll have something for y'all to get drunk to at Gay Pride.
Who says we drink?
Honey.
You have us all wrong.
We were drinking before we got here.
Pride.
We could go. What are you doing after this? Maybe we should go to the bar.
Go to the bar.
How shocking would that be?
Unannounced. Okay, Fernando and Greg, the biggest gay icons in San Francisco, to walk into the gay bar with Katy Perry on their arm.
My manager, Bradford, is a big old Delta queen from Mississippi.
Oh my God.
Tunica, Mississippi. And he's real cute. He looks kind of like
Tunica. That sounds lesbian.
Yeah, actually, when you think about it.
That's my assistant.
Is there anybody surrounded, Katy?
No, it's interesting. He looks like a bit like Harry Connick Jr.
Oh, really?
That's kind of hot.
Yeah, he's on the lobby if you want to go.
Yeah, I'll sit on his lap later.
Can we send for him?
Yeah, he's hot. Bradford!
I mean, you're the big draw here. I don't want to run away from you to go. What if I left?
You always leave for good peni.
You know, that's so funny. Mm. Have you ever seen Margaret Cho in her act, how
I
a gay
her.
Man will leave a straight woman in a second, make her take the bus home if he finds a guy?
Right. Oh my gosh. That used to be my life before I met my boyfriend. It was kind of like, you know how your friends go out and you're like, so-and-so's gone. They just left.
Yeah.
It's like, we'll see them tomorrow, I think.
Speaking of your boyfriend, let's get into him. He's on the cover of Rolling Stone.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
Sticky? Well, I hope it's not.
It's dirty.
We're Facebook friends, and apparently that was your J.O. material.
My what?
You said it was your jack-off material.
Oh, my J.O. material. Yeah, I don't do that much, obviously, because I don't know how to.
I hope that wasn't you that said that. Well, someone talks very dirty for you on your Facebook.
No, that's me.
Okay. Are you Facebook friends with Katy?
I'm Twitter. I'm a Twitter girl.
Are you?
Yeah, sometimes the Twitter feeds to my Facebook. I don't do a whole lot of Facebooking because I never went to college. Hell, I didn't even go to high school.
I didn't know you needed a degree.
Spell.
You didn't go to high school?
No, is that true? No.
Really? No, girl.
No,
I feel like I'm sitting at a bar with my friend Sandra.
No, girl. I don't know where. So did you drop out or you just decided not to go?
Well, first I was pregnant. I'm just kidding.
It was a gay dude, wasn't it?
No, that's funny.
Did you sleep with a gay guy?
I have never that I know of. I've made out with a few gay of my gay friends, you know.
But you knew they were gay. I'm talking about dating a guy that, you know.
But I had a friend.
The high school quarterback.
But I had a friend that had one, and someone had told me, look, your friend's boyfriend is G to the A to the Y on the low. And I was like, I ain't about to break that news to her because she'll get her claws out. And it's like, it's hard. It's hard.
Yeah, that's not something.
You
that's
can't
something
tell
like
your
someone
friend.
That you think you're going to marry and you're
right. He's gay. He's not.
She would have like whipped me.
You leave an anonymous note
or
something like that. You don't tell her face
to face. Do you leave all your girlfriend's anonymous notes?
Yeah. Well, you know, I learned this.
After you sleep with their boyfriend.
No, you know what? This is what I learned. I was in Vegas recently with a girl and I'm still hungover with a girlfriend of mine, and I tried to tell her that this guy that she's going back to is a loser, ain't got no job, you know, he doesn't have his crap together, and we got in a huge fight in the middle of like this bar in Vegas. I'm like, I'm trying to have a good time, why did I even open my mouth?
Because you're probably a good friend.
You probably care. I did, but I didn't after that.
You didn't care, but it doesn't matter what you say.
But girls don't want to hear that.
Right.
Oh my, where is that
girls,
from? Because these guys
LMFAO.
I don't know.
I don't know, but like you hear it after you've had a couple of drinks and you're in the bar and you're just like,
what is the world coming to? Thank God we will have a polarization at 2012.
The people, there was a group of dudes from San Francisco doing that in this bar that we were at, and they kept doing it over and over again. They tried to molest that girl I was with because she's got
big ones.
Stacked. Yours aren't bad either.
Yeah, your boobs look fantastic.
Well, thanks for painting the mental picture for all those listening.
Oh, this is going to be video too.
There.
We got video going.
They're
here
popping
too,
out.
You know, in my Daisy Duke type dress.
I also learned from your Twitter, I guess, that you were ATVing yesterday. Were your boobs popping out when you were doing that?
Girl, I was wearing a sports bra.
Oh, thank goodness. Those things can get out of control.
Yeah, it slapped me in the face, and it's not even the ATV taking me down. It's my own body.
What? Is that just something you like to do? You like to hop on an all-terrain
vehicle? Show your boobs?
Or show your boobs.
I get slapped in the face by my own boobs. This is the dirtiest conversation I've ever
That'll
had.
That'll be great for the next video.
Yeah, I'm sure it would get a lot of YouTube
It
hits.
Would. I mean, don't you want to be Lady Gaga?
Do you enjoy making music videos, or is it just a complete pain
no,
in the
it's
ass?
No, it's one of my favorite things. Touring is probably my top favorite thing.
Okay.
And then making music videos is, you know, like, I love the whole process. I love the whole kit caboodle. Even
where does Russell fall
into
all that?
He's in it. Okay. I actually just left him about 2 hours ago. We went to, like, the Grand Canyon area for Memorial Day weekend. That's where I was ATVing.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah, it was fun. It was really fun. We took my cat, Kitty Puri.
I bet you did. It wouldn't be a weekend without it.
Come for. Yes, she had fun.
So now I had read like this rumor that he was getting cold feet about getting married. I mean,
oh my God.
That's a really nice thing to come in and tell her.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. First minute you meet her.
I'm really going to just like lay my soul on the table now. You really know how
jerk.
To win over a girl's heart.
Sorry.
Let's just go.
Listen,
drink.
He is the biggest groomzilla you will ever meet in your entire life.
Do you
life.
Watch that movie, that TV show, Bridezilla? Have you ever seen
no,
it?
No, but if hilarious. I were to tune into an episode, it'd probably be like an episode of my life with him. I swear to you, like when we go or have breakfast and we go out and we have to stop by those newsstands,
yeah.
He always picks up like a... He picks Star up like no a Q or
oh.
Enemy and then a Bride magazine.
And he imagines himself in, as a bride?
Monogrammed.
Or? Oh my God.
Everything is monogrammed. He's got like the little pages dog eared and everything.
Is he more prissy than you? Obviously he is.
Oh my gosh, he is. Like, have you seen his hair?
I've seen
don't
it.
Don't mess oh, wow. with his hair.
I mean, you're like, I didn't even go to high school. I don't know how to read this magazine. Right?
Yeah. I'm going to shave his head one day and then use it and put it in as extensions.
Oh, if he ever pisses you off, that's a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Shave
Samson
his head
and
while
Delilah.
He sleeps. Would you do that? Are you a
psychotic?
Psycho girl? Like, are you one of those girls?
Yeah, we make the world funner to live in.
Yes, you do.
No, I've got my on and off button switches, and it's just, you know, just know your role and don't cross the line. Or,
oh my God, what is
what
like
are the
worst
rock?
Thing a guy
know your
can
role?
Do?
Know your role, or I'll
actually,
show you.
Worse yet, I want to know like what was like that moment when you broke up with a guy or he broke up with you? I'm sorry, and you felt like you had
me.
To, well, I know he's a dumbass for breaking up with you, but
nobody
you know.
Would ever live to break up with you, right?
What have you done for revenge?
What have I done for revenge? Well, I usually just write songs about them and make the whole world sing along, which is the greatest. I mean, I don't really like believe in horrible revenge. I mean, I have done some crazy things. One time, a guy went on vacation with a girl and said he was turning off his phone because he needed some time to himself. So he went on vacation with a girl, and I found out where. I found out where he was on vacation. Then I found out where they had went, and I called up every hotel in the area, claiming to be that girl that left a diamond bracelet
and, to find out where they were staying.
And I swear by like the sixth hotel, they're like, "Oh yes, we remember." And I was like, "Oh yes, it was so fun." Now. Tell me everything!
Wow. Yeah.
But mostly they just get songs and they're not fun to sing along. Mm.